What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, and today I'm going to show you how to build this starter cottage house place thing. Stay tuned! All right, guys. So here we are. It's a new thing. It's a modded build pack called Build Pack. So I've been working in conjunction with Joe Tato, and who is the mod author for Practicalities, and a couple other people to get some ideas about doing a building mod pack. And so here we have it. It's mod pack. It's not ready for a release yet. We're taking it to a couple of different launchers. We're not really sure exactly where it's going to go yet, but I wanted to kind of give you guys a video of it so you could see stuff and things, see what's going on. So check it out. What over here? What are you, buddy? A little dog statue. Oh, a little dog statue. Bye, dog statue. Oh, it squirted out all the stuff. So you know what? Let's go ahead and grab this dog statue, and we'll kill that and squirt this stuff up here. Bam. All right. So first thing we're going to do is start off by making a scale model of the build. That's pretty much what it's going to look like. It's like a 1/11th, 1/14th scale model. So you can get an idea, you know, pretty much this is what it's going to be. All right, so let's start off. So over here, we're going to do an 11 by 11, okay? So we're going to start off here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then we're going to start off over here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Do we like that? Do we like it right there, do you think? Let's move it over a couple of blocks. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3. And we'll pop these off right here. Not quite exactly the placement that I wanted. All right, so here we go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So since it's modded, we've got a super builder's wand. Bam, 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 like so. All right. So all the stuff and things that we're going to be using, or pretty much all of them, the build, are right inside of here. And I've got it preloaded, so we can go ahead and go back. If we mess up our inventory, we'll be good to go there. Let's grab some carpenter's stairs. And then let's go ahead and start off. Let's just put three stairs right here like this. And let's take our walnut wood and squirt it right there. Bam, bam, bam. All right. So then we're going to use walnut. We're going to use spruce wood as well. And for our spruce wood, three blocks over, we're going to start making our spruce wood kind of, you know, our walls. So this is what we're going to do like this. All the way around here. And then, let me see here. What are we going to do? So one, two, I think, for a door. And then one like this, like that. Yeah, that'll look good. So a door here and a door here. So what we did is we went, you know, two back and then two spaces and then a block and then a diagonal block and a space and a block. So that's basically our house. And just to make this easier, what we're going to do is go like this. We're going to take our super builder's wand and we're going to go up. Let me see. One, two, three, I think four. Bam, bam, bam. It's a thing. So let's go ahead and cut our doorway out over here. I think right here will be good, and then right there, there's our doors. So let's start off here by making a window. We're going to make this window. Oh, you know what, actually? Let's put these back. Let's grab this glass right here. We're using the bubble glass, and we're going to use the regular glass instead of panes. The panes actually don't look that great. The texture's a little bit wacky. And we're going to grab our carpenter's wedge slope, and we're going to put two in the side there, and then two in the side there. We're going to come down to the bottom. We're going to do two wedge slopes here and two wedge slopes here, okay? Then we're going to hold shift, and we're going to turn this into the oblique exterior slope, and we're going to put an oblique exterior slope there and there, and then there and there. Bam! It's a thing. So then we're going to take our clear glass, or a bubble glass, pop it into those guys. We're going to take our spruce wood, pop it into these guys down here. Then we're going to take this guy, which is a chiseled dark oak wood planks in disarray. And we're going to pop them in right there. It's a thing. All right, so let's go ahead and pop back here. Squirt these, pop those guys off like that. Kind of. Let's go over one more. There. Amazing. First window, done. Pretty much done. Build over. No, not quite. So let's put our doors in real quick. We'll do a carpenter's door here, two carpenter's doors here. We'll take our carpenter's hammer. We're going to make these guys like that, and that guy just like that. And then we're going to apply that dark oak and disarray texture to all of this like that. Perfect. All right, let's go around the outside edge and do a little work here now. What we're going to do is We're going to add some upside down stairs like this, like this. We're going to leave the one in the corner there. We're going to leave the one in the corner here. And add these upside down stairs all around the outside edge. Like so. Giving it that detail. And then a lot of the detail that's going to come in the build is actually going to be in the end. So, and I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do this in one episode or not. We're going to see. I'm going to see if I can do it in one episode for you guys. So then we're going to take take our walnut wood, and we're going to apply that walnut all the way around to the carpenter's stairs. So if you're unfamiliar with modded stuff, did I just manipulate that? If you're unfamiliar with modded stuff, a carpenter's block is basically kind of like a blank slate block. It allows you to place the block like a stair or there's a bunch of different kinds, and then paint it with a block pretty much is what you're doing, kind of, sort of. So, all right, so now we've got our edging all the way around there. And you know what I don't have in here? We're actually just going to use regular cobble. And then we're going to use, is the mossy in here? Let's go ahead and grab mossy. So I really don't like many of the chiseled cobblestone blocks. They're just not my fave. So, we're just going to use regular cobble underneath here, kind of like a foundation. We're just going to do it random. So we're going to pop these guys off. And I'll give you the random statistic. I'll tell you the mathematical formula for random. Regular, mossy, regular, regular, mossy, regular, mossy, mossy, regular. That's a call. See? Random completely. All right. So let's go over here and do it again. Now, the random pattern over here is regular, mossy, regular, mossy, mossy, regular, mossy, regular, regular. See? That's exactly how it's done. Pop these guys off here. And then our foundation will be done. Like this, like this. Look, random. Looks perfect. All right. Oh, and we have Kevin. Did I tell you guys? We have Kevin. He has a hat on. We have hats in this mod. So, mod pack. So, Kevin's got a hat on. It's fine, Kevin. Calm down. I'm not going to try to take your hat, man. Oh, my gosh. All right. So, let's go ahead and pop a couple windows out. Let's take a look inside of here. I'm thinking right here. We got a window. And then on the back, let's do one here, here. Now let's change this up right here like that. There's two windows there. And then over here we will do, I think, right here and then right here. That looks good to me. So let's go ahead and grab our bubble glass and fill in all of our windows. Like so. And like I said, the panes, unfortunately, the texture is wonky on them, so we don't want to use those guys. All right, so now we've got our windows. Let's go ahead and use this guy, the dark oak wood strip. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a dark oak wood strip here, across like this, and then right there. And we're going to kind of do a little bit of an edging all the way around the house here, thinking like that. And so, starting to get that detail going. I'm going to try to, see, I was thinking about how I could do this, and I could go ahead and do like all of the big blocks and then move into all the detail, but I want to add some of the detail in the beginning too. You know what I mean? So, here we go. Like so. Oh, and this one's going to be a little wacky. It's a little hard to place these underneath the carpenter's box, as you can see. There we go. Like that. Now for the window here, what we're going to do is we're going to place one of these down, two of these down underneath here. Then we're going to add another one, and that just kind of doubles it up. We're going to go up right here like this, and then on the edges as well, we're going to add these two. So we're kind of adding that window frame type look. So now I've got a window frame thing going on. All right, so let us grab these guys, these spruce wood planks, right? So what we're going to need to do here is we're going to place these inside of here like this as kind of a roof. And you'll see why here in a second. First of all, it's going to add some extra space to the inside of the house instead of using a full block. So that's kind of nice. And unfortunately, we can't use the builder's wand for this, so we have to place these guys all by hand. And we're going to cover over the entire roof. A roof. However you'd like to say it, it's totally fine. And this is going to be our, like I said, our upper floor. Like so. We'll leave this hole in here, right here. All right, so let's head back outside. Let's take a look. Let's take a step back. See what she looks like. So I feel like we need to start getting our roof going. So let's go ahead and grab our carpenter's wedge slopes. And then on the edges here, we're going to go ahead and add in our guys like this. Like this? I don't think so, actually. Let's go ahead and pop those guys off. Let's take the spruce wood, put a line of it right here, like that. And then now let's go ahead and do this. So I want there to be a one block space between the top of the window and the bottom of the roof there. Put another spruce block here. We'll go ahead and add this. And then we're going to go and build our roof out. So with the carpenter's blocks, it's a little bit tricky to place these. And you really do need to, at every single level, replace a line of blocks like this. Okay? And you just want to do that. You can try to do it without it or try to place it on the side or whatever, but I find that it's just not going to work out for you if you do that. So then you can go back through and break your blocks off like this. All right. Like so. Bam, 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 bam. So I'm actually going to come over here. We'll place our line. And then what we're going to do is right here, we're going to place a line of blocks straight over, okay? So now we've got kind of like this upper part area, this kind of upper flat area place. And now we're starting to make like a room basically up top here, a second story room of some sort, like that. All right? So then we're going to take our wedge slopes again. Like this. Place, man! Come out here. We're going to place one here. This is going to be a little bit tricky. We'll play with it, though. It's going to be good. All right. Like that. Like this, like that, and like this. And I'm actually going to place out the rest of the roof right now. Just kind of on my own, and I'll BRBs. And we're back, and I realized that we actually have kind of made, well, I wouldn't say a mistake as much as that. I did something that I want to kind of change. What I'm going to do is pull this whole roof back by one block, okay? So I don't really like the way kind of some of these angles are looking, so I'm going to make a change. What we're actually going to do is pop this straight off like this. And pop this guy off here. Now we're going to go ahead and grab our spruce wood. We're going to make this upper room really kind of small, only 3 wide, like that. And then we're going to go ahead and take and make our doorway here. And the reason why I decided to make this change is now if you look, let's pop that guy off there, pop that guy off there. Now if you look, what that's done is kind of aligned this door in a central way, and it's also aligned this window in a more central way, so it's going to look a lot better. All right, take our carpenter's door, squirt it back inside of there, bam, bam. All right, check this out. Now what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and take these wood strips. We're going to grab a dark oak painting frame and the screw gun. These are both from Bibliocraft. So let's grab our double down below, pop a double on there, pop a single on there, take 2 of these guys on each side like that. Now you take your screw gun, you shift and right click on one of the frames and then the other one. And then it attaches them like that, and they look like shutters. Really cool, huh? All right, sweet. So let's pop these guys on. All right, sweet. All right, so let's pop all these guys on. Like that. And then get your screw gun ready. It's like working with power tools on a real house, man. We got that. We missed that one. Oh. Did we get it? All right, we got it. Then we're going to take our strips. Do doubles on the bottom and singles on top. Like so. Bam. It's a thing. So now we got some windows going on over here. Let's pop these guys off here. Pop these guys off here. Like so. Then we're going to take our wedge slopes again. We're going to put these down underneath to give that roof that really nice, like, angle. You know what I'm talking about? A real nice angle. Now, on the top one, you actually do this guy. Whoa. Why is it that you are not... No, what? What? Why do you hate me? All right, let's pop these guys on. Let's do this. Upside down right here, all right? Now, pop these ones off and put them in here and here. And you see what we get is this really great aligned slope here. So when we put in our dark oak wood, the distressed wood, you'll see. And we can actually pop a full block in there like that. Well, geez Louise, I'm not really digging that much. Let's go like this, pop these guys off. Maybe we won't do that. See, I feel like it would be too thick. So let's go ahead and just do it this way. It'll be great. It is great. And then we've got to kind of take out something right there, pop that guy in like so. Bam. It's raining. All right. So now we've got our roof kind of sussed out. It's looking good. Put this guy upside down inside of there. Do these guys. Like so. Now this thing's all going to get painted with this distress pattern. The dark oak wood, the disarrayed pattern. All right, now we got this all filled in. Let's go ahead and take our Super Builder's wand. Let's put some of the spruce wood on our hotbar. I filled in the other side already, fill in this side. And then for up here, I didn't really show you guys this. I'm gonna go ahead and show you now. We'll pop a couple of these off. Just go ahead and take your Carpenter's Wedge Slope, select it on your hotbar, hold Shift, go down to Carpenter's Prism Slope, and that's gonna give you that picket roof look. So then you can see we got that right there, like so. All right, so down here, we're gonna need a door. I'm thinking like this. And then we're gonna go ahead and grab our carpenter's barrier, all right? So then we're gonna go ahead and place this all around the outside edge here. Up to right there. We're gonna take the carpenter's hammer, and I'm thinking this is the one we're gonna use. And just to show you real quick, we're gonna take the walnut wood. Paint this guy up like so. You see, we're kind of getting a little bit of a fence thing going on. And actually, I do believe if you were to go ahead and let's change these over. If you change your first carpenter's barrier, I'm pretty sure they'll all place the same way. Yeah, like that. It's a little bit more efficient to do it that way. All right, so now we got a little fence going on top of the house there, kind of like a little opening. You know what I mean? It's like a little covered deck on the top there. Grab our carpenter's door, and we already got that guy like so. And I'm thinking that we're going to go with like a big open doorway like that for up here, except our doors didn't place quite right. There we go. All right, like so. Let's pop a window in right here. Grab this guy. Squirt that in there. Grab that dark oak strip. We're going to put four around here. Now, there's a block called a nook that we could stick in the corners, but we're not going to use a nook. We want to keep it like this because it's going to look a little bit more kind of old-timey, distressed, so to speak. And we're going to pop these blocks off here. And be careful not to destroy your roof. So we're going to pop all these off on the inside of this room. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add a walnut roof. So with a carpenter's block, you can add a second block to the inside or to the outside. Inside, whatever layer you'd like. So you can see here we still have that that shingle pattern, but inside of here we've got this. So, and we can do that on all of these guys. The other cool thing is that inside of this room now, because we've taken out the solid blocks, the light's going to shine through. So we get a cool light effect in here now that we didn't have before. All right. Bam. It's a thing. All right. So now let's grab our carpenter's ladders. Come down here. We're going to put these up like this. Yeah, that's good. And then we will use the distressed or the disarrayed dark oak wood like that. All right, cool. So get the exterior coming along pretty good. It's not looking bad at all, man. Get this going. We got these windows. We got those windows. I'm thinking we need another window inside of here. So let's go right here. 1, 2, 3. Bam, bam, bam. Take these guys and cover them up. Like this. Sweet! All right. So should we just get this room done right now? Let's grab our carpenter's bed. We'll squirt it down right here. Let's grab Mr. Crayfish's Furniture Mod bedside cabinet. Pop that there. And then we will grab Mr. Crayfish's Furniture Mod wooden table. We'll pop that right there. We'll take our hammer. I like this bed. There's all sorts of cool beds you can choose by right-clicking on here. I think for this build, we're going to go with this bed right here. So then we're also going to take this cup, and we're going to put it by the bed by shift-clicking it. There we go. And with these Mr. Crayfish's Furniture Mod stuff, you actually have an internal inventory, which is pretty cool. We're going to take this stereo from that mod and pop a little stereo over there. Oh, it got an achievement. Fireworks. You get fireworks in this mod when you get an achievement. Woohoo! All right. So we kind of got something going on over here. Oh, yeah. Let's grab this guy. Some more detail right there like so. And then we will, let's do a little bit of some strips along the outside edge here. Kind of give it a thing. Make it a something something. Like that. All right, cool. This room is looking good. I like it. So let's go inside of here. Let's grab our strips. Why is you open? Well, actually, let's wait on that. Check this out. Let's go ahead and load this back up. Let's grab these blinds. And we're going to go ahead and use these guys on all the windows like this. Let's get to this Venetian blind look, right? Pretty cool when you actually put them over like so. I like it. So then I'm thinking a couch. And we have a couch right here from Mr. Crayfish's. So there we can go like that. Let's grab some cactus green. Cactus. And we can dye this couch. We'll give it like a dark green, earthy type look. And let's grab a painting. Let's spell painting. Let's grab a painting. And we'll stick a painting up. Oh, that was a good one. Yeah, we'll do this guy. So just do a little teeny single painting right there, and then we'll outline it with our dark oak strips like so. All right, cool. Let's do a kitchen cabinet thing. So we have that too from Mr. Crayfish's. We're going to go ahead and right here, we're going to lay in. You know what? I think 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I'm thinking 1, 2, 3, 4 like so. Or we'll do 3. Yeah, we'll do 3 right inside of there. Let's grab a cauldron. And some water. Put our cauldron down, like in the center. Ugh! Wrong water. There we go. Like this. And then we're going to grab some oak stuff and things. Let's grab an oak painting frame. Put a backsplash on this guy, like this. And we'll take our screw gun again, and we'll connect all these. So we have like a little bit of a backsplash. Let's take oak wood covers. These guys here. And we'll put one right here and one right here. And then we're gonna need oak wood strips. And we're gonna make a little bit of a table thing. You know what I'm saying? Little working area. So there you can kinda get, you know, get your stuff and things going on. And it's really simple in here because we're doing this like, you know, it's a like a woods cabin-y, woodsy type deal. All right, so let's do next, I think, this flower pot deal. Let's grab apple sapling. So an apple sapling, piece of dirt, and a medium flower pot from Garden Containers. We're going to pop that flower pot down right here, put dirt in it, and then drop that apple sapling in. So we kind of get a little bit, you know, we're getting a little bit of some beautification going on up in this piece. Let's grab our wooden table, wooden chair, plate, toast, cup. All right, check this out. Two of these tables from Mr. Crayfish, a chair and a chair. We're going to drop a cup right here. There we go. Shift click it on. Our plate, and we're going to put a little piece of toast on it. So we're having a little bit of a morning breakfast. It's so good. Grab a candle. Oh, now we got a little bit of light. Beautiful, beautiful. Now, wait, this guy here, Dark Oak Fancy Bookshelf, I think we're going to put here. Dark Oak Fancy Workbench, pardon me. Grab that. And then we're going to need some books. So let's grab a stack. And then if we click these in like this, we get some beautiful little books there for our working bookcase. Looking good. So the interior, it still needs a little bit of work. Let's grab these strips. And then with this, you got to be careful with the couch. If you add a strip there, it takes the arm off of it. So we can't get too close. We'll just add some of these around here. We can actually go underneath our kitchen sink there. I'm thinking like that. Looks pretty good. Not bad, not bad. All right, let's have a look around here. Kind of got of our minimalist interior going on. Unfortunately, we can't add strips to the top because we've used these spruce wood covers to occupy that block. We could maybe do something like this. Add a little bit more detail right here. Kind of give it that breakfast area feel. I'm liking it. I like the interior. We want to keep it kind of plain, you know? It's not supposed to be super amazing. Just kind of plain. So, and then up in here, we've got this going on. This is looking good too. You know what? I think out here, we need to have a table and some chairs too. So we're gonna go ahead and do a 4x4. We're gonna add a chair. Oh, backwards. Oh, just destroying the whole universe now. So perfect. All right, chair. We're gonna add a chair here, and we're gonna add a chair sideways like that. Just kind of a little bit different. Let's grab our candle, and we'll plop that down over here. Give it a little bit of light out here. So it's looking good. I like it. Now, one of the things that we can do that's really cool, check this out. Let's grab these carpenter's blocks and let's add some walnut right here. Now, what we're going to do is if you add extra blocks, remember we did that up on the top underneath where the roof was? We're going to add some extra blocks in here and it's going to add a distressed look to the area. Now, actually, let's grab our stair. This is going to be tricksy. There we go. So we're going to go like something like this. Add that extra block in a couple of different spots here. Like this, like this, like this. And we can just add one right there. Whoa, whoa. Oh, no. Okay. Check it out. So now we've got kind of like a thing going on. Like it looks like, you know what I mean? A little distressed. A little bit different. Let's add some details here. Let's grab our vines and this oak leaf strips micro block. So for our vines, we're gonna start coming up here and you just shift click them in to one of your, any of the carpenter's blocks, and you're gonna get the little vine look going on. So over here, we can do like another one right here, maybe a couple here, and just wanna do pepper it in a random type fashion all over the roof. So we got one underneath like that, like so. We can kind of do it almost in a pattern where it's kind of growing, you know, like so. Like that. This, and when you start adding the details in, this is what really kicks the build off, man. This is where you start to really see it become a thing. Like it's no longer just kind of randomness or I don't know. It really just kind of makes it, I don't know, makes it more beautifuler. So there we've got some of that going on there. Let's grab our oak leaf strips, and then what we can do is start doing some stuff and things here. Oh, you know what we really need to? Let's grab this dark oak strips. This is gonna look good. I think we're gonna need to place it like that. Oh, this is gonna be difficult. So I wanna do a strip around the top here too to add a little bit more detail to this outer deck. Let me see here. There we go. Oh yeah, baby. Now it's a thing. Beautiful. All right, cool. So then we're gonna take our leaves and we're gonna start doing some stuff like this. We'll double up right here, add one and add one. Where we see some of these vines coming off, let's do a little bit of some of these leaves coming off. So it's kind of like we're extending the vines almost. You know what I'm talking about? Can we get in there? One right there. Let's add a vine. Like that. Now we've got a little bit, you know, kind of like the overgrown look happening. Like over in here, we can get some. Add a vine right here. and kind of do them a little bit diagonally. And on the corners of the house, too, you can do is add one right here and like one on the other side, like that. And put them on the corners is kind of something that you think you might not want to do all four corners. It's kind of important. It really adds a look to it. Let's go ahead back and load these. Let's grab our carpenter's blocks again, and this time our spruce wood. And let's head around now and start adding in some of the distressed spruce woods. So when I say distressed, I just mean that, you know what I mean? We're kind of adding that extra texture here. Like so-ish. And then it really starts to give it a look. It's becoming a thing, peeps. Like that. And when you take a look at it now, it just gives it a little bit more texture. It makes it look a little bit more old, kind of broken, kind of urban. Not urban. And especially on the back here, we've got a lot of open wood here. So really what is important if you have like a big flat space like this. Like so. You see? It's pretty cool. I love doing that stuff with the carpenter's blocks. All right. And we need a little something right here. And right here. All right, cool. So it's looking pretty good. I like the look of the outside of it. We got enough of the distressed stuff and things going on. The inside, kind of like I said, super minimalist looking interior here. Oh, we lost a ladder. Let's fix that up. And the blinds really pop it off too. I love those blinds. You know what? Up here, we could actually do that too. Let's just load this back in. Pop these blinds. Perfect. Some blinds in right there too for a little bit more detail in the upper area. I feel like we're going a little bit long. So we're gonna keep going though. We're gonna try to finish this up pretty quickly. Let's go ahead and get at Mr. Craze. Let's grab spruce wood hedge. Check this guy out. So spruce wood hedge, different than, oh, we got an achievement. Even though I've already placed it. So a little bit different than leaves, and actually places in the center of the block with a little bit of an edge work around it. So this thing looks really great. So we're going to add some of that right in the front here, and then we're going to do it again right here. We're going to come all the way back to like this, and we're going to go diagonally one. We're going to add this water barrel. So like a little spot where we're keeping water. And then we're going to kind of do like a little bit of a couple of holes in the back. And over here, we're going to dig out a little trench. I think like this. And we're going to grab some water. This is going to be a little bit of a long building tutorial. I'm going to be honest with you. I could probably have broken it up into two, but hey, let's just keep doing it. I'm having a good time. So when you add water, I'm not sure. I think it's maybe nature. I'm not sure what does it. We get a little bit of cattail action going on here. And let's grab a hoe and like this, we'll hoe it out. And then we're going to go ahead and add a bunch of different vegetables in. Rhubarb, turnips, beets, delicious garlic, amazing broccoli, and some chili peppers, and some mustard seed. And then we're just going to place these kind of completely randomly all around inside of here. Like this. And our garlic. Just kind of filling it up. Turnips. Rhubarb. Rhubarb. Then let's go ahead and grab our reinforced watering can. It'll probably work a little bit better than bone meal here. So we'll grow these guys all up with the reinforced watering can. If you use bone meal on them, they actually will harvest. So with this, it's kind of nice because we're going to get that growth, and it's not going to automatic. Like, you're not going to accidentally harvest it when you're building it. All right, cool. So let's clear that out. Let's grab our carpenter's barriers, and we got our hammer. Let's go ahead and squirt one of these guys right here. Bam, bam. And we'll cover this with the same fencing that we used in the, you know, above in our outer deck area there. And then we'll use our walnut to tie that into the build. So we got a little area right there, a little farm on the edge of our little house. And you know what, guys? I mean, I could go on and on. And with modded stuff and things, you can do that. But I think, you know, if you take a look at our scale model, it's pretty much exactly what we got in the house. What do you think, Kevin? Stop giving me the finger, man. So I hope you guys had fun hanging out, doing stuff and things with me, building this modded starter house in the beginning of the Build Pack series. You're absolutely going to see more of it. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the thumbs up button. If it's your first time hanging out, subscribe for more stuff and things. And yeah, that's going to be it for today. May the stuff and things be with you.